In this video, I'll be explaining important rules behind Tekken 7's combo mechanic. This is not a tutorial and I won't give you advice, only informations. The purpose of this video is not to explain combos from scratch. I will assume that you already have a very good knowledge of comboing. With that said, let's get started. Most people at first glance would say that Tekken has a single combo system, but the game actually has three: standing combos, air combos, and wall combos. Those three are all very different from each other and almost completely independent as well. Now, the way Tekken keeps track of these combos is through three counters. The game also keeps track of when a floor break or wall splat happens, but floor breaks won't reset until the enemy gets off the ground. This is done to avoid you trying to pick up the enemy and break the floor again. The three combo counters are incremented in different ways and doing so yield different results based on which one is being incremented. The overall hit count is incremented through successive standing hits. It has no effect on pushback or damage. The air hit count is incremented by hitting an airborne or wall splat enemy. Every hit increases the pushback and decreases the damage you do. The wall hit count is incremented by hitting a wall splat enemy. The more hits you did, the faster the enemy will fall off the wall. That counter is kept throughout the whole combo, even when there are multiple walls. But the wall hit count is not as straightforward as it seems to be. It follows specific rules. If you do a high wall splat, you get a free hit on the wall. If you do a mid wall splat, you get no free hit. And if you do a low wall splat, you get one less hit. Free hits are hits that do not count at all toward the wall combo. You can even get multiple free hits if they happen in quick succession. In both of these combo, the game doesn't think the enemy has been hit at the wall up to this point, allowing the exact same ender for both of the combo. And to be more precise, free hits are not really tied to the wall splat height. You can get free hits as long as the enemy's feet have yet to touch the ground. Whether the wall splat will be low or not depends on if the enemy's feet already touches the ground when the wall splat happens or not. Low and mid wall splats tend to look very similar, but low ones will have the enemy start falling down immediately. Also, every hit at the wall adds an extra point of damage. Balcony and wall breaks do not increment the wall hit count, but will still benefit from that extra point of damage. Now, going back to air combos. Catching an enemy midair or launching an enemy yields the exact same scaling and pushback. And that's because the launcher hits the enemy standing, therefore not counting at all for the air combo. The game also has a lot of multi-hit launchers, and among them, some may launch only with the last hit, keeping the 100% damage scaling throughout the whole attack, and keeping the same pushback as a single hit launcher. As I just said, damage scaling stays at 100% while the enemy is standing. This is important because it means that any string on the ground, natural or not, will always hit at 100% damage. This is why a combat combo can be so deadly. A lot of hits happen while the enemy is standing, keeping the full scaling for every attack. This is also why Kazuya's counter hit down forward 2 into perfect electric does so much damage. The enemy is still standing when the electric hits, making it the launcher instead of the down forward 2. These rules apply to every character, with one exception.
Bring it on!
Giz has a unique combo system that makes his standing combos drop in scaling as they get longer. The first two hits will always do 100% damage, the next one does 80%, and every hit after that does 10% less, down to a minimum of 10% itself. And it even applies to his non-natural combos. But Giz's standing combos have a strange behavior with his rage art. If you do an instant air fireball, you can immediately follow up with a rage art, which will hit at full scaling because it's the second hit in the combo. But if you do two instant air fireballs, the rage art will hit as the third hit, and therefore should get a lower scaling. It does indeed, but only for the first hit. The second hit will always get a full scaling when hitting a standing enemy, even though it doesn't on an airborne one. This actually makes his rage art more damaging than Deadly Rev when used in a standing combo, as a bigger part of the damage is left unscaled. Anyway, this combo system is isolated from the other ones, and a high amount of standing hits will have no effect on the enemy once he is launched. When an enemy becomes airborne, it incurs a damage reduction to every hit you do afterward. It starts at 70% scaling, and 50%, 40%, and then 30% for the rest of the combo. This happens regardless of how the enemy went airborne. But hits are not the only thing that can make the scaling go down. When an enemy hits a wall through a wall splat, wall bound, or even a self-wall splat, the scaling itself is reduced by 10%. With the scaling at 70, that means it will be lowered to 63%. Starting a combo with a wall break still applies the reduction. But that's not even all, there is one more thing that can lower damage in a combo, and it is floor breaks. Breaking a floor is even worse damage-wise than a wall splat, as doing so incurs a 30% scaling reduction, which does not go away until the enemy wakes up. It applies before the wall damage reduction. Damage maluses, once they apply, are kept for the remainder of the combo. A hit also always does a minimum of 1 damage, regardless of how low the scaling can be. There are also damage bonuses like clean hits, counter hits and rage, but they apply differently than maluses, as they increase the hit damage itself instead of the scaling. They also apply in a very specific order, as they do not stack together. Contrary to popular belief, having less health in rage does not increase the damage bonus it provides. It only increases rage art damage. Speaking of rage arts in combo, they may appear to do multiple hits, but none of them will decrease the damage scaling. A rage art that hits at 70% scaling will keep that scaling throughout its whole duration. Despite that, the counter hit bonus will only apply to the very first hit, giving at best 2 more damage. Giz and Akuma are the exception to the scaling rule, as their unique rage arts will always get a full scaling on the last hit. And Akuma's rage art also doesn't get any extra damage from a counter hit. Paul's rage art is a bit special as well when done in combo, specifically because it can be cancelled. If you do cancel it, it won't decrease the damage scaling nor increase the pushback, allowing essentially what is a free hit. And if you do it right after a launcher, it will keep a full scaling for a fixed 20 damage. It even ignores wall splat damage reduction, but still does not ignore the floor break reduction. Some rage drive can guarantee a single 80% damage hit after landing in combo, which can still get affected by wall splat and floor break reduction. Also, special multi-hit attacks like Kazuya's Rage Drive or Devil Jin Heaven Gate will count as only one hit, and only decrease the damage after the last one. Speaking of the specific attacks, they can at times behave strangely. The second hit can sometimes hit at 100% scaling and not count at all toward the combo. And I'm not talking about delaying the attack after a wall splat, which is an entirely different thing. So you must be wondering how to do this. Well, there are two conditions. First off, the attack must be the very first one after the launcher. And secondly, there are two possibilities you can pick from. The enemy is falling to the ground, but not down a wall. This includes falling on the front, side, back, or falling down. Or the enemy is airborne, and the attack connects after the enemy has bounced off the ground. This includes bouncing after a floor break, balcony break, or screw attack. You can tell the enemy has bounced when there is smoke on the ground. The hit must happen after the smoke appears, not on the same frame. After a Devil Twister, you have a 7-frame window to pull that off. But after an electric, it's a single frame. And, as I said, if you do succeed in doing that, the whole attack will not decrease the pushback or decrease the scaling. You are getting a free hit in the combo. I know, right? Those aren't the only attacks that have a strange behavior after the enemy touches the ground. Jin's 3+4 is normally a 2-hit attack, but after the enemy touches the ground, it only does the first hit. You can even combo off it. Don't do that. Damage modifiers can be pretty confusing when stacked together, so I'll try to clarify them a bit using an example. A Dead Fist do 36 damage. If it's a counter hit, it gets a 20% damage bonus. If that counter hit happens on an airborne opponent, the base scaling changes to 70. If rage is added on top of that, that's a 10% bonus after counter hit. If the opponent has been wall splat before and one hit has already been done beyond the launcher, that's a 10% scaling reduction on a 50% base scaling. Finally, let's add clean hits and floor break, which respectively add 50% hit damage and reduces the scaling by 30%, and let's also add more hits, and we get this. Once the final hit damage is obtained, it is then rolled down before being applied. Training mode has a feature that shows the damage scaling for the last hit you did. It's pretty straightforward. Dual launcher, 100% scaling, do a job 70%, but then you turn on Rage, and suddenly the job has a 57% scaling. Try to replace it with a different job, and now it does 66%. And this is why you should not look at the hit scaling in game. It normally shows the scaling it's supposed to show, but when you introduce damage bonuses, then it recalculates the scaling as the difference between the original attack damage and the final damage that is applied. So don't go and look at that percentage too much, as it is not very useful. Now, let's talk about wall slump. It's an old term and I could not find any better one, so I'll just use this one. When an enemy is falling from any wall, there's a small window in which they will be in a special state, but still in combo. If you hit the enemy during that window, the hit scaling will change to a fixed value that depends on the attack itself. Most attacks will hit at 60% scaling, but some others, like Gistro, can hit at 100%. Some special attacks like Heaven Gate can hit at 60% scaling on the first hit, then 100% on the second hit. These wall slump hits will still, however, get affected by floor break damage reduction. For example, Geese Ground Throw has a 70% damage scaling after floor break, and hits that were at 60% scaling are now at 42%. Hits that would normally result in wall break, balcony break or floor break, will lose these specific properties when hitting a wall slump enemy. But some attacks like Kazuya's Rage Drive only floor break on the second hit, where the enemy isn't wall slump anymore, therefore benefiting from a floor break anyway. A wall slump enemy is also not wall splat anymore, and therefore can be resplat. This is heavily used in combo videos, where a hit that normally could not resplat because the enemy is already at the wall, lands as a wall slump, and resplats the enemy further away. But wall slump hits can never pick up the enemy themselves. There needs to be a second hit quickly afterward to send the enemy flying again. This all can be used on certain characters to produce unconventional wall combos. And more than not counting as wall hits, wall slump hits do not increase the pushback nor decrease the damage whatsoever. They are free hits in the combo. A wall slump opponent can also never get hit by a high and cannot be tailspinned. As for enemies falling to the side or back, the wall slump timing window is much smaller than the regular one, but still exists. Finally, Rage Arts may also hit a wall slump enemy, but it will not result in the Rage Arts starting. Only the first hit will connect and do 10 damage scaled at 60% like other wall slump hits. There is also a grounded state, which is quite similar to the wall slump state, but happens when the enemy is fully underground. When the enemy reaches that state, it usually means that the combo is dropped. But as I showed you earlier, some Rage Drives can force this state and still allow an extra hit. A grounded hit always hit at 80% damage, but still gets affected by wall splat and floor break reduction, which lower the scaling to 72, 56 or 50%. The hit will also always result in some very big pushback. But there are attacks other than Rage Drive that can force a grounded state and still allow an extra hit. For example, Jin's Punch Parry, Geese 1 plus 2, or Akuma's Back 1 after watching long enough. But like with Wall Slump, a grounded hit can never be a high, cannot tile spin, cannot wall, floor or balcony break, and does not start Rage Arts. But this pushback can be nullified when near a wall, allowing multiple hits instead of a single one. And again, as with Wall Slump, two quick successive hits will pick up the enemy, giving you a full combo of a grounded hit. Note that the grounded hit itself is not counted as part of the combo, it essentially acts as the launcher. But there's more to grounded hits than mere pickups. Akuma and Elisa both have ways of rendering an enemy grounded in a combo and picking up again as a new combo. Akuma's pickup is quite weird because it's specific to floor breaks. After a floor break, he can do a forward 1 plus 2 to render the enemy grounded. He then gets a tight window where the enemy becomes grounded, but still in combo. A down 3 into Shoryuken, or just a heavy Shoryuken, can then pick them off the ground. Basically, any two quick hits that hit grounded will work. For Elisa, her QCB3 makes the enemy grounded, and allow for a QCB 2 plus 4 pickup in combo. But on top of requiring precise timing, it also requires the enemy to be at a specific angle to be guaranteed. This still means that with a full super bar, Elisa can get 3 full combos out of 1 with 2 grounded hits and 3 screws. Well, this concludes about everything I know so far, and as you can see, Tekken is a lot more complicated than you would expect. There's no doubt I must have missed some edge cases and important behaviors regarding what I covered. In which case, feel free to write in the comments whatever I might have missed or whatever mistake I might have made. I hope you enjoyed learning all this stuff and will make good use of it. Thank you for watching this video.
だまだ今は人生半ばです。